Pennsylvania when I was a lad. Our castle was cold, yet we never were sad. We learned to be happy, we danced round the hall, and learning to count was the key to it all. By counting each count, I knew just where to start. And one special step stayed close to my heart. One, two, three, spread out the cape. One, two, three, twirl round the floor. One, two, three, left foot you swing. One, two, three, then start to sing. One, two, three, loud as you please. One, two, three, counting with ease. One, two, three, doing the Batty Bat.
Batty, 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 Batty.
One, two, three, count.
Batty, 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 Batty.
One, two, three, count.
Batty, 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 Batty.
One, two, three, count. Won't you dance with me doing the Batty Bat?
Oh, my happy childhood in the Carpathian Mountains. How well I remember.
So now in my own castle, I can enjoy this wonderful dance that I learned as a boy. I see just how wise was my whole family. They taught me to count, and so now look at me. I'm counting and dancing, and I swear that it's true. If you do the same, you will be happy too. Come, we try again. One, two, three, spread out the cape. One, two, three, twirl round the floor. One, two, three, left foot you swing. One, two, three, then start to sing. One, two, three, loud as you please. One, two, three, counting with ease. One, two, three, doing the Batty Bat.
Batty, 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 Batty.
One, two, three, count.
Batty, 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 Batty.
One, two, three, count.
Batty, 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 Batty.
One, two, three, count. Dance with me doing the Batty Bat.
Ha ha
ha ha! One, two, three, count!
Oh, yes! Batty Bat!
Sharpener. What good is a pencil without a point? You can't do anything with it.
Vankarian.
Pardon me. Excuse me. Huh? Excuse what? Me, please. Excuse what? Me. Okay. Okay. Oh, thank you.
Red, don't.
No.
Okay. Let's see.
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Now, let's see. Where was I? Dear Aunt Polly, thank you. Ah! Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Okay. Thank you.
Oh, did you mean?
Oh, well. Let me see. Thank you for the pencil. Oh, okay. Sharpener. Oh, no.
Baseball. You say he's playing baseball?
Sí, él juega baseball.
On a bright spring day in Central Park, the score was 3-2. And though it was a practice game, the fans would cheer and boo. Batter up was heard across the park, for the umpire's voice did boom.
And with that, a stranger appeared on the field and was given a look of doom.
Get off the mound, the players yelled, but the stranger wouldn't move. He wanted to play, that much was clear, but everyone disapproved. Except one boy who said, give him a chance, let's see what he can do. The stranger made a spectacular catch, it seemed he almost flew. The crowd went wild and the stranger smiled as they begged him to remain. And for this reason he played all season and brought them exceptional fame. And brought them exceptional fame.
3,409 sheep. 3,410 sheep. 3,411 sheep. What? My sheep? Where are my sheep?
Your sheep, my friend, are tired of jumping. Every night it's the same thing. Jump, jump, jump. Count, count, count. Well, we are tired of jumping. We've had it. Sheep need sleep too, you know.
Oh, this is terrible. Oh, I have no more sheep to count. And counting is what I love to do. I've already counted all my bats. I've counted the flowers on the bedspread, the spots on my pajamas. Oh, but wait, not to panic. Ah, yes, here it is. 24-hour emergency counting service. We deliver. The number, yes, okay. Yes. Hello? Yes, operator. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, please. I love that number. Somehow it has a certain ring to it.
24-hour emergency counting service.
Yes, yes. This is the count. I need somebody to count in a hurry. My goodness, that is a hurry. Come in!
Hey, what seems to be the problem?
Oh, I've run out of sheep to count.
Oh, well, I got just a thing for you. Yeah, we're running a special on Swiss cheese. Count the holes, sleep like a baby.
Oh, that's not enough for me to count. I am the count.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. Look, I guarantee, you count all the paper clips in this jar, you'll be snoring in dreamland in no time.
Oh, I'd finish those in no time. No, it's not enough. I really need, what I really want, is more sheep to count.
More sheep? More sheep. They always want more sheep. I was afraid of this. Okay, buddy, you just get a little comfy and cozy in your little bed. I'll be right back.
I can hardly wait to start counting sheep again.
Bah. Bah.
Well, it's not perfect, but it'll have to do.
Oh, boy, I hate this. Bah!
One pretend sheep.
Bah!
That's two pretend sheep.
Bah!
That's three pretend sheep.
Bah!
Four pretend sheep.
Bah!
Five pretend sheep.
It's not an easy way to make a living.
Six pretend sheep. He's getting tired. Seven pretend sheep. Oh, I love it.
Howdy. My name's Vern. This here's my gang. We're special sort of cowpokes, and we'd like to tell you a little bit about ourselves.
We travel all around the West just looking for a chance to satisfy our passion for adventure and romance. We do the things that cowboys do, like fussing with our herds. But what we really love the most is reading words. We're readers of the open range. We're readers of the open range.
Hey, look, boys, what's that sign say there?
Well, I can read that. It says, Gopher Junction.
Yeah, Dodge City.
Yeehaw.
We read the signs along the road. We fill the wordless gaps. Read labels in our cowboy hats and the cowboy boots and chaps. We do the things that cowboys do, like fussing with our herds. But what we really love the most is reading words. We're readers of the open range. We're readers of the open range.
So you got your Acme cowboy boots on.
Yeah, and I'm wearing my International League of Garment Workers shirt.
Sometimes we read right into town to get some extra licks. We look around for words to read, that's how we get our kicks. We see them up above the stores along the dusty street. But riding through to read the town is really exciting.
Dark Carnation!
Reading trees. We're readers of the open range. We're readers of the open range. We're readers. Open range.
Oh, look at there. There's Dolphin Gazette.
Oh, yeah, and the Dentist.
Oh, look up yonder. It's the feed store.
Oh,
look, Jake's and Harry the Blacksmith.
Oh, yeah.
Sanfarilli.
Yeah.
Well, boys, I'd love to stay and read some more, but I think we better head for home.
Yeah.
We can come and find a few more signs on the way.
I hope so. Readers of the open range.
Yeah, we're
sometimes I imagine that I would like to be a knight in shining armor in a castle by the sea. A knight in shining armor with a princess by my side. I'd have a magic feather and a horse that I could ride. And the king would say,
Sir Ernie, you're so handsome and so brave. Please rid us of this dragon breathing fire in his cave.
Then I'd get on my horse and I'd start to ride. I'd travel my way through the countryside. I'd come at last to the dragon's cave and I'd yell, Mr. Dragon, you'd better behave. And the dragon would be so scared of me that he'd run away. And the kingdom would be free. And I'd dip my hat. Imagine that. Imagine that. Imagine that. Sometimes I imagine that I would like to be a daring, bold explorer sailing far across the sea. I'd set out on a sailing ship to find a distant land. I'd gaze across the ocean with my telescope in hand. And the captain would say,
Ernie, there's a big storm drawing near. You're our finest, bravest sailor. You must grab the wheel and steer.
And I'd grab the wheel in the wind and rain. I'd steer the ship through the hurricane. I'd guide the ship with a steady hand. I'd lead the way toward a brand new land. I'd spy the land lying safe and near. And I'd try land ho! And the crew would cheer. And I'd tip my hat. Imagine that. Imagine that. Imagine that.
Ooh. Yep.
Sometimes I imagine that I would like to be a person whose name Ernie, who looks quite a lot like me, who likes the things that I like and who does the things I do. And I don't have to imagine, cause I'm Ernie, me, that's who. And I tip my hat. Imagine that. Imagine that. Imagine that.
I have a little plant. I always give her water. Cause you see, she really loves her water. And she says, thank you to me. Even though I never hear it, but she says, thank you to me. I have a little plant. I put her in the sunlight. Cause you see, she really loves the sunlight. And she says, thank you to me. Even though I never hear it, still she says, thank you to me. She'll never give me flowers or cuddle like a pet. She'll never give me pretty fruit to eat. What you see is what you get. I have a little plant. I guess I'll keep on caring. Cause you see, she really likes my caring. And she says, thank you to me. Even though I'll never hear it, still she says, thank you to me. I can tell it very clearly when she says, thank you to me.
Well, she would if she could talk. Wouldn't you, little plant? Okay, you're welcome. Well, that's easy for you to say. Okay, later.
Thank you.
tropical island with the mango moon and banana sunshine. And on this tropical island there lives a cousin of mine. Sometimes he lives in the water, sometimes he lives on the land. Sometimes he likes to go sun himself on soft Caribbean sand. He's a Caribbean amphibian. He likes to hop in the tropical sea. Caribbean amphibian, a frog in the coconut tree. The flying fish and the turtle, they've seen him hop where the pineapples grow. He likes to see all the islands, so island hopping he goes. Sometimes he hops to Jamaica, sometimes to Haiti he hops. Sometimes the warm Puerto Rico beach is where he finally stops. He's a Caribbean amphibian. He likes to hop in the tropical sea. Caribbean amphibian, a frog in the coconut tree. Sometimes he lives in the water, sometimes he lives on the land. Sometimes he likes to play music with an all amphibian band. He's a Caribbean amphibian. He likes to hop in the tropical sea. Caribbean amphibian, a frog in the coconut tree. Everybody!
Caribbean amphibian. He likes to hop in the tropical sea. Caribbean amphibian, a frog in the coconut tree.
A frog in a coconut tree.
Welcome to Lifestyles of the Big and Little, the show that takes you into the fabulous world of the very, very big and the very, very little. Hello, I'm Dickie Tick. And today I'm going to take you to visit the fantastically tiny home of the fabulously small Sylvia Little. Each morning, Sylvia Little wakes up in her little itty-bitty bed and takes a brisk jog around her itsy-bitsy little bedroom. Tiny hot tub for a bit of relaxation before breakfast. I asked Sylvia how it felt to be so very, very little, and here is what she had to say. I couldn't have said it better myself. And now you've seen how a typical day begins in the fabulous world of the fantastically tiny Sylvia Little. But what of the fabulous world of the very, very big? For that, our cameras went to the incredibly huge home of the fantastically big Lyle Large. Here in the monstrous master bedroom, we found a bed so big it would not all fit in the picture at the same time. This is the bed of Lyle Large. We were hoping to have a word with Lyle, but he couldn't be reached for comment. When Lyle Large climbs out of his amazingly big bed each day, he heads straight for his incredibly big bathroom, where he brushes his teeth with an unbelievably big toothbrush. And then Lyle is ready to face the day in the fantastic world where the very, very big and the very, very small live the fabulous lifestyles that you and I can only dream about. That's all for now, but be sure to join us next time for Lifestyles of the Big and Little. Until then, this is Dickie Tick saying, ciao, Bambinos!
And now it's time for the hippest, newest, best-dressed detective show on television, Miami Mice.
Yo.
Are you the Miami Mice?
Yeah, JP here.
Tito, ¿qué pasa?
What?
He's coming at you in Spanish.
What?
He speaks Spanish, man. ¿Qué pasa means what's happening?
Oh, well, ask me again.
¿Qué pasa?
Oh, it's awful. It's just terrible. Oh, you've got to help me. You see, I took my rubber ducky to the repair shop, and I can't get him back. Oh, please help me.
Okay, chill out, man.
Huh?
The repair shop. Is anybody there?
No one was there. I checked it out. Oh, I'll never see my rubber ducky again!
Hey, I said chill it.
Yeah.
Hey, let's scope out this shop.
What?
I'm with you.
Yeah. Oh, we're gonna scope out the shop. Mm. You see, there's nobody here. That's what I was telling you. And my rubber ducky is inside.
Yeah, they must be laying low. Hey, Tito, let them know they got company.
Check. Hey, how do I look, man?
Oh, hip. Yeah, real hip. Now, cool.
Well, Tito to you, partner.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, guys, can I please get my rubber ducky?
Right. Fashion check is over.
Yeah.
Attention inside, this is Miami Mice speaking. We have your shop surrounded. Send out the rubber ducky unharmed. Do you read? Send out the rubber ducky.
Oh, my poor rubber ducky. Do you think there's been foul play?
We demand the release of the ducky.
Hey, yo, hey, Tito, check out this sign.
What sign?
Man.
Sorry, what sign, man?
Oh, this sign here, it says Corrado. You see, that's the name of the repair shop. This is the Corrado Toy Repair.
Tito.
No. It's not the Corrado Repair Shop. What, are you new in Miami? People speak two languages here.
Well, I know that. They speak English and Spanish. But what does that have to do with my rubber ducky?
Listen, pal, that sign doesn't say Corrado, it says Cerrado.
Cerrado?
That's right, Cerrado. That means closed in Spanish. Hey, why don't you just come back when the shop is open? Get your ducky then.
Yeah, right. When it's open, not Cerrado.
Yeah, but it's 10 o'clock in the morning. They should be open now, and nobody showed up. What if nobody shows up? What if this shop stays,
Cerrado.
Yeah, what if the shop stays Cerrado forever? Then I'll never get my rubber ducky.
Buenos dias, everyone. Time to get a new day underway.
Oh, thank goodness! She's here! She's here!
Oh, sir, sir, calm down, sir. What a greeting. Woo!
Do you have my rubber ducky? Do you have my rubber ducky?
Easy, sir, easy. Yes, I have your rubber ducky.
Another score for Miami Mice. Case is closed.
Ah, you mean case is cerrado.
Hey, let's board, man.
Yes, let's go.
Oh, thank you, Miami Mice. Thank you. Drive carefully! Oh, I hope they fastened their seatbelts.
Oh, I hope so too. Now, let's see. Yours was the rubber ducky with the broken squeaker, see?
That's right, yes. I was waking up Bert, you know, with ducky squeaks one morning.
See?
And then Bert, well, you don't want to hear this story. Do you have my rubber ducky?
Yes, sir. It will be ready on Thursday.
What?
Shardlou Hall in Atlantic City, Oregon, it's the letter of the day, Pageant! And here is your host, Guy Smiley!
Thank you, and welcome back to the letter of the day, Pageant! This is Guy Smiley, America's favorite television personality, with the moment you've all been waiting for! Yes! In just a few seconds, we are going to name the winner the letter of the day! Right! Right! Now you all know our category winners. For swimsuit, the letter S! That's lovely, lovely S! All right! Now for congeniality, the letter C!
What's yours?
All righty. And now for talent, the letter T, who tap danced. Okay. All right. And now, the moment you're still waiting for, when we name our letter of the day. Yes. Our five finalists R, A, E, I, O, and U. Okay. Aren't they great? Okay. Now the fourth runner-up is the letter A. Well done, A. Our third runner-up is the letter U. Yes, thank you, U. Our second runner-up is the letter I. And now, that leaves E and O. Yes, yes, one of them will be our letter of the day. Yes. So the first runner-up, and should our winner be unable to serve, you will replace it in every word in the dictionary. The first runner-up is the letter O, so our letter of the day is E.
Gentlemen, E, the letter of the day.
Look at you.
Look at you.
Aren't you wonderful?
Wonderful.
No matter we hold dear.
spell with words you start so well, like easy and elbow and ear. You're everywhere, look at you.
Look at you.
So educational, the finest in the alphabet.
This is the most exciting day of my life.
Oh, when we look at you, we think of all those wonderful E words, like egg and eat and emu, not to mention entrance and exit and ear and eel. And the always beloved entomology.
Yes.
Look at you.
Look at me.
Aren't you elegant? You're the ladder. We can't forget. You're so exceptional. So educational. The finest in the
alphabet.
Isn't she wonderful?
Guy Smiley's Casino by After 3.5. Travel arranged by Trans World Bicycles.
So wonderful.
Last night as I was lying, just lounging in my bed, heard such a loony howling, stood my hair up on my head. Over to the window, flip the floodlight right on. Hey, there's a letter L on the loose, leaping across my lawn. I heard the letter L let out a
la la la.
A little rebel L, he cried
la 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 la.
I heard the letter L let out a
la la la.
The little rebel L, he went
la la.
Just wanna live for loudness, and don't say I'm too young. I was born to go la 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 at the top of my la la lungs.
I heard the letter L,
la la la.
The little rebel L, he cried
la 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 la.
I heard the letter L,
la la la.
The little rebel L, he went
la.
Discussion be about?
Hey, what else? Party! Yeah!
Let's take our first caller. Party line.
Hello?
You're on.
Hello?
Yeah, what do you want to discuss about partying?
Am I on?
Yes, you're on. Your head at, buddy?
First, I'd like to say that I really like your show.
Well, all right!
I'd like to say that I think partying is great, and I hope the partying never stops. Woo, woo!
Well, woo, woo to you, too. You got it. Whoops, gotta take another call. Hello, party line. The discussion is partying.
Yeah, well, the way I look at it, there's good partying and there's bad partying, but any partying is better than no partying. You get my drift.
Oh, heavy. Well, thanks for sharing the thought with us. Looks like you got a good thing going on there. Yeah, ooh, sorry. Catch you later. I'm coming. Yo.
Hello, is this party line?
Yep, on the air and in your ear.
Look, I'd like to add something to this discussion. I think this whole partying thing has gotten out of hand. Doesn't anyone stay home? Doesn't anyone like a quiet, old-fashioned evening at home? Like making fudge or pasting photos in albums?
You mean you don't like partying?
No, I don't.
But why are you calling party line?
Listen, this is supposed to be a discussion. We're supposed to be sharing our thoughts. So that's my thought. I don't like partying, and I don't like people who like partying.
Well, yeah, but... Gee. Well, I guess that's what happens if you have a discussion. People have different ideas to share. Any other calls? Huh? No? Doesn't anybody out there want to discuss partying? No? Well, gee, maybe partying is all finished. Maybe the day of the party is over. Maybe the party monster's gone the way of the dinosaur. probably a wrong number. Yeah, hello, party line.
Hey, Leo, my man, it's Duke. I've been trying to get through to you.
Well, why?
Hey, you gotta come over. We got a crowd over here. The music is blasting, the food's on the way. Where are you, man?
Well, I was having this discussion, you see.
Well, forget it. This is...
A party! All right! I'll be right there! Oh, that's it for party line. I got a party! Yeah! I like a good time. I like to party.
Hi, Big Bird.
Oh, hi, Bob.
What's going on?
Oh, they're getting ready to perform a quartet.
A honker and dinger quartet? Sounds interesting, Big Bird.
You think it's silly, huh? Well, let me tell you, Bob, they just rehearsed and they sounded beautiful.
Well, beautiful or not, Big Bird, it can't be a quartet because a quartet needs four musicians. And I only see one, two, three.
Ah, but number four is coming right now. So if you just take your seat, I will introduce him. The Sesame Street Chamber Music Society is proud to present our very special guest, Yo-Yo Ma.
Thank you, Big Bird. We will perform for you the Beethoven Quartet for two honkers, dinger, and cello.
He wrote that? Ludwig van Beethoven? The famous composer?
No, Murray Beethoven, the famous honker. Thank you.
sure to stay tuned to WCTW today for... Yes, for the best in TV afternoon drama, stay tuned for The Edge of School, where today, Katie will say to Phil,
"Gee, Phil, this is our first day of school here in the classroom, but what are all these other people doing here?"
I think, Katie, I think that when you go to school, one of the things about school is that you, meet new people.
Then, later this afternoon, be sure to stay tuned for another school, where today, Bruno says to Felicity...
Felicity! Here we are on our first day of school! What's that grown-up person doing there in the front of the room?
1 + 1 = 2.
That's the teacher, Bruno. He helps us learn stuff here at school.
Oh!
Then be sure to stay tuned for All My School Children, where today Dick will say to Vanessa...
Oh, teacher, I know the answer.
Vanessa.
Yes, Dick.
You're supposed to raise your hand when you want the answer.
Oh.
Didn't you know that?
No, I didn't, Dick, but I will from now on, thanks to you.
And then, finally, be sure to stay tuned for Love of School, where today, Dwayne will say to Martha...
Martha?
Yes, Dwayne?
I love school, Martha.
Dwayne?
Yes, Martha?
I love school, too.
So stay tuned all afternoon to WCTW, where it's always...
school in the afternoon.
Oh, howdy! You know, running a ranch is tough work. That's why I put up this sign right here. It says... Cowgirl wanted. I need someone to help me out around here.
Howdy. Howdy, 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 howdy.
Well, howdy yourself. What can I do for you?
Oh, you see, I came about the cowgirl job.
Well, you're not a cowgirl.
I most certainly am. I'm a cow, and I'm a girl. That makes me a cowgirl.
Nope. That makes you a girl, Kyle.
Well, let's not quibble over details. Do I get the job or not?
Well, I do need help.
Yes, you do.
And I guess I can't be, picky.
No, you cannot.
Well, okay, you're hired.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yes. Welcome to the Double Bar R Ranch.
Ah.
That's our brand right there. A big R, underlined twice.
Well, what does the R stand for?
Why, ranch, of course. Oh, and R also stands for rooster. See, rooster. That's our rooster, Roy.
I see.
He'll be waking you up every morning at sunrise.
Sunrise?
Yep. And the first thing I want you to do is climb up there and fix the roof. That's another R word.
You want me to climb all the way up there on the roof?
Yep. And after that, you gotta ride out on the range and check the herd.
You want me to ride on the range? What am I supposed to ride?
Well, most of us ride horses, but You're too big for that.
I should say so.
Yeah, well, I guess you have to run, run.
Run on the range?
Uh-huh. And while you're out there, I want you to round up the rabbits.
Rabbits? Oh.
Yep, this here's a rabbit ranch. We gotta take good care of our little bunnies.
No, let me get this straight. You want me to rise with the rooster, repair the roof,
yep,
run on the range,
uh-huh,
and round up the rabbits? Well, that's an awful lot of work for one day.
Oh, that's just what I want you to do in the morning. I got more chores for you in the afternoon.
Okay, I see. Well, so long. It's been nice talking to you. Yes.
Hold on there. Where you going?
To get some rest. That's another R word. All this talk about work has worn me to a frazzle. Ta-ta.
Well, I do declare. I guess they just don't make cowgirls like they used to.
And now it's time for your favorite reunion show. Here is your life. And here's your favorite show, favorite host, Guy Smiley.
Hello, this is Guy Smiley. And I'm hidden in this trash can because I'm about to give someone the surprise of their life.
That's right, 2102 Shady Lane, here is your life!
Yes! Surely you don't mean me.
Yes, we do, 2102 Shady Lane. And you wouldn't be standing here today if it weren't for our first guest. Listen to this voice.
I remember 2102 Shady Lane when she was just an idea in my mind. And then I drew a picture of what I wanted her to look like.
No.
Yes.
It couldn't be.
It could, and it is. The man who decided what you were going to look like, architect Frank Lloyd Left. Come on in. Yes. Wonderful.
Hello, 2102 Shady Lane.
Hello, Mr. Left.
Tell us, Mr. Left, whatever gave you the idea for making a house look like that?
Beat me. I just started doodling, and there she was. Hmm. Two bedrooms, one bath, living room, dining room, kitchen, and oh, the cutest back porch you've ever seen.
Aha! Uh-huh. Well, thank you very much, Mr. Left. Thank you very much. We'll see you at the party afterwards. Well, 2102 Shady Lane,
yes.
Once the architect's drawings were finished, you were ready to start being built.
Yes.
Can you recognize these voices?
I saw 2102 Shady Lane grow up brick by brick.
Me too.
I don't believe it.
Well, believe it, because here they are, the people who built you, Mr. Bricklayer and Ms. Carpenter! Come on in! Wonderful, wonderful!
Hi, Guy.
Hi.
I found a picture of 2102 Shady Lane when she was just being built.
Oh, look at that.
I want to tell you, I lay down every last brick on her.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw him do it. And I lay all the wood. I put in all the wood, the floors, the windows, the doors, and 2102 is still standing.
Yes, she is.
But right now, I wish I could sit down.
Oh, well, thank you all very much. Thank you. We'll see you at the party afterwards. All right. And so they finished you, 2102 Shady Lane. And then the day came when you were ready to be lived in. And a family moved in. They had a little boy and a little girl.
We made our first mud pies in your yard.
And we broke many of your windows with our baseball.
Oh, dear. It can't be.
It is. Please welcome little Tommy and Sally Wilson, now grown up and with children of their own. Come on in.
Hello.
Hi, 2102 Shady Lane.
Hello, Tommy. Hello, Sally.
Oh, sorry about those broken windows, dear.
Yes, and our muddy messes, too.
Don't even mention it. It was a joy being your home.
Aww. Well, thank you all very much. We'll see you at the party afterwards.
Thank you, guys.
All right. Yes, 2102 Shady Lane. The Wilsons lived under your roof for many years. But perfect happiness was not to be.
So true.
The kids grew up and the family moved away.
It's gone.
And they were not the only ones who did. There used to be a house standing next door to you. She was like a sister to you until she was moved to make way for the new interstate highway. But here she is. We brought her back. Formerly 2104 Shady Lane, now number 1 Main Street on the other side of town.
Oh, this is unbelievable, man. Simply unbelievable.
Well, it's going to get even more unbelievable, 2102 Shady Lane, because here are Tommy and Betty Lou and Carmen and Paco, who used to ride their bikes through your flower bed. Yes. And to remember this wonderful homecoming, we're giving you free of charge a new paint job. And this book of memories. And a lovely charm bracelet. And there'll be a party at the Audubon Memorial Ballroom. Yes. Yes. So join us again soon for another episode of Here Is Your Life. Wonderful.